All right, good morning, and welcome at another installation, whatever installment of our work on the Komar burial shroud. And today we are just gonna try and at least finish our first pass through by tackling the last few lines. They're long, they're difficult. But I just really want to get this over with. So, without further ado, let's start. Again, briefly the setup. Here on the top, I have the burial shroud number 3 of Komar, the one we're working on, and in the second half. Below, we have burial shroud number 2 from Gapoiapa, the one with the most complete reading. Everything that's marked yellow here occurs in number 3. So you see there's quite some overlap. Now, where should we start? Probably at this Ao Takuana. So above line 30. Something like engine. I guess here we have outer corner, so alpha, epsilon, omicron, epsilon, tau, alpha, kappa, omicron, epsilon, alpha, nu, alpha, sigma, omega. Then delta here. Pauka, but what do they have here? Out Aquana, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maybe 6 letters. Then this looks like Omicron Upsilon. Two, three letters. So delta. Then unreadable traces. To here, marks in omega. Away gun. Well, is this a well there? No. Do. traces. Traces. Epsilon. Okay, pretty useless. Line 30 then. Yeah, jongens. This is like two keran. Aika. Okay. Here, Aika. Two letters before that. Pop letter nu. One, two, three, four, five, six. Is this Domenculo? Maybe. Yeah, this may be it is a mu. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, maybe six or seven letters. Ten is cool. This is a kappa. Tau met is de simpt. Nou. Mu epsilon tau tau epsilon. Epsilon. TG. A copper, clear. Hey, nothing up, and then here delta. Delta alpha. Then a whole bunch of nothing. Thirty-two. It doesn't get any better, does it? this line. Unreadable here. Follow, there's an alpha here. Disaster. Draw alpha. Two, three letters. Three. Nothing. Nothing. What, which line is this? This line. It goes here, then it's in this lacuna. It's here. Maybe there's an epsilon here, but it's like, honestly. La-di-da. Oh, then at the very end. So, maybe this here. Maybe that's this. That could be. It is. So often. So this part here we have. Just maybe the LN, blah 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 blah. This is so difficult to see. Susan. Ah, this is Jesus in Christosin. Okay. Barely readable, but I'm reading here Iota, Eta, Sigma, Omicron, Sigma, Omicron, Epsilon, Sigma. Nu with a superlinear stroke. Well, where does this take place? They don't have this here. Okay, so the text diverges also. It's not the same in this part. Okay. Where does this whole ah part start? this is like, this happens already line 35. So this should be like this. Then here should be axontioles. Impossible to read. How do these lines go? Yeah, that's how I begin. A name. Here are E's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should be reconstructed. There should be 7. Here. And this name here. Characters. Ignatius. O. Cap. U. Aranios. Okay. Should have nos on the next line. Nos. And then omegas. Absolutely unreadable stuff, but how does this line go? Nos. This line goes here. Here it says Aya. Letter. This Christ is on the next line. Theotok. Ayagille, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 to 4. Then we have Teo Toku. Yes, okay, so we have this. Teotoku he. Marianos, Horuse, did they mix up Maria with Parthenos? Because here it says Maria. Yeah. Ruse me. Ruse. Save me. Then the line with Krista here. There are magical signs there. Amen. Seems. He's there. Yeah. Gios, Gamma Yota Oricon Sigma, Gios 2. There. This is completely unclear. Describing this one. These are like horries or something. 1, 2, 3. Medical signs. Let's see here, the ring letters. And then we have Komar anapauson, Komar anapauson, Komar anapauson, Komar anapauson. And okay, that's it. That's it for the entire thing. Not much, but we at least finished the first pass, and now we can start refining. And maybe, just maybe, I'll be able to get a better picture, but I think that this is really it. This is really it. So now I have to, probably what I should do now first is create a good edition of this, all the grammatical commentary, and then see if I can fill in some more gaps based on my understanding of the meaning of the text, and then return to this. And we of course also still have the shard from Kasir Ibrahim. We may actually be able to do some work there too. All right, well, that's it for today. At least we got through the text in several marathon sessions. So done. I'm so done with this. I need to let it rest for a couple of days. All right, see you next time with more burial shrouds.